Hey guys, welcome to Ted's Garage and my first video ever. This is a video about this 2017 V9 Bobber, Moroguchi of course. There are a lot of videos on the internet about this bike, so if you want to know what if the brakes are like, what it rides like, what it is like to own one, you will find lots of those. Instead, on this video, I'm going to focus on the parts catalog that Moroguchi has. It's quite extensive and it has a lot of beautiful machine parts made by a company called DPM. When I bought this bike back in 2018, I bought a new as a 2017, and I bought it just to go to work. I didn't really care much about the bike, but that changed within a couple of months after riding it. Believe it or not, it became my favorite bike. The riding position, riding around the city is very easy. It's a very lightweight bike. And I really like it a lot. Because I liked it so much, I started buying a lot of the parts from their parts catalog. And the problem that I was running into, there were not enough pictures of the parts installed. And some of them were expensive, some of them reasonably priced, but it's kind of difficult to lay out so much money on things that you don't know what they're going to look like on the bike. Anyway, I have installed just about everything, and I'm about to show you all of them, what they look like. And we'll start with the front of the bike. Of course, this is the grill that LSL makes. It is an Italian company. They make accessories for Aprilia, for Moroguchi, for Ducati. This particular grill came from MG Cycles. It's about $130, and the colors, the yellow stripe with a fender stripe matches very, very well. It's made out of aluminum or stainless, I believe. It's powder coated, so I cannot really tell you what kind of material it is. The mask, the instrument cluster mask, it is made by DPM. It's Moroguchi. It is made out of aluminum, and I believe it's powder coated. Now, one thing that I changed was the handlebars. The handlebars are actually original. The clamp is from DPM. And the other thing that I did was I wrapped the handlebar itself with leather. Took a piece of leather, punched a couple of holes, and laced it. Coming closer, this is the billet aluminum reservoir cap that they use for the master cylinder for the front brakes. You don't have to remove the original. This one goes on top of it. And they supply you with a couple of small spacers and bolts. The mirrors, I believe they are for the larger cruiser that Moroguchi has. And one thing that I did was I used this extension because it falls too close to my elbows. And every time I had to look on my rear view mirror, it was kind of hard. So I used the extension that solved that problem. The grips are billet aluminum and they have those rubber inserts. They're also made by DPM. It's on the Moroguchi catalog, and also the bar ends. One thing that I noticed after installing them was a little more vibration. The originals, as we all know, are made out of rubber and they absorb quite a bit. These don't. These are the brake lever and also the clutch lever made by DPM. They are adjustable, unlike the original ones, and they are very smooth to pull the clutch. The clutch is not heavy. It gives you very good leverage for the front brake. They're excellent. I like them a lot, actually. Now, over here, we all know how ugly DOT lights that Motor Goods installed are. What I did was I bought these blinkers from Bach. It is a company in France that have a lot of parts for Moto Guzzi, for Triumph, for BMW. And because I couldn't install them on the bike in their original position, what I did was I bought this adapter that is actually for a Triumph. Let's not forget that Triumph, Moto Guzzi, and all the other European brands, they all shop in the same parts bin. So a lot of the pieces are interchangeable. Now, as we move towards the triple clamp, this is the cover that Moto Guzzi makes for the triple clamp. And below it, over here, it is the cover for the horn and also the voltage regulator. It is a beautiful billet aluminum piece. It is absolutely gorgeous. Same goes for the fork brace. I didn't see any difference between the original and this one performance-wise. The original was good to begin with, but of course this one is machined aluminum. It's absolutely gorgeous. The gaiters, the fork gaiters, they're made from Bach in France, and they are leather. They're absolutely amazing. They do have some small tiny holes for venting whatever moisture gets trapped in, or any rainwater that may go in. They are very durable. They already have some kind of a treatment where they don't soak with water. They are very water repellent, actually, excuse me. All right. Now, the other thing that I did was, just to make the bike a little different, I also wrapped the forks over here in leather. They're laced on the inside. I don't know if you can see it. There it goes, right over here. Just to be a little different, you know. Some people loved it, some people hated it. Yeah, I guess the jury's out there. The other thing that I did, since we are on the front end, was I replaced the front rotor with a rotor made by Breaking. I believe it's a British company. And I also, over here, you will see, I made a ring around the instrument cluster. This bike has very, very little plastic. Everything's made out of steel or aluminum. And having a plastic instrument cluster, it was just terrible. So I made this piece out of bronze. My cousin is a machinist. He made it for me. It is absolutely beautiful. Okay, moving on. This phone holder, I purchased this from Amazon, I believe. It's very inexpensive, maybe about $20 or something like that. It is adjustable, and it works very, very well. There is no bouncing around. It mounts directly onto the clamp for the clutch, so it's seamless. You don't have to put any additional clamps over the handlebars over here or anything like that. It's a pretty nice, clean. It gives it a very nice clean look. This is the optional gas cap that Moto Guzzi offers, and it's also lockable. To me, it didn't really matter. The original was beautiful as well, just in case I ever leave my bike outside, which is very rare occurrence. I don't really leave the bike in the street or leave it out in the rain and the elements. This is, call it a garage queen. All right, now, moving on to the seat. This is made by Bach. It is a leather seat, and it's the softest leather you'll see. It is absolutely beautiful. You don't send your own seat to be reupholstered. They actually buy the base from Moto Guzzi, and they make their own seat. Comfort-wise, I don't see that much of a difference. It is a little better. It's a little softer than the original. The original I found it to be very hard. This one is a little better, but not by far. You know, it's still after an hour and a half to 2 hours worth of riding, you want to get off this motorcycle. This is not an across the country tour. Okay, as we're moving a little lower over here, these are the engine guards that Moroguchi sells. Obviously, I never dropped a bike, so I cannot tell you how effective they are, but my opinion is they're beautiful to look at, but don't expect to save your engine. Over here, they make these stainless steel covers for the headers. And what I did, I also wrapped the exhaust pipes with titanium lava wrap. The pipes, even the original pipes, they don't emit that much heat. They're double walled. After I put this wrap, I noticed that it was even less heat coming out. On a hot summer day, it makes a difference. It makes quite a bit of a difference. Performance-wise, I didn't see any changes, to be honest with you. These are the frame bolt covers. If you see one of the original Moroguchis that doesn't have it, it's just two ugly bolts. But anyway, I'll get back to that later regarding the bolts. This is a dipstick from a T5, which of course didn't fit. And what I end up doing was use a stainless steel adapter and then adjust the length of the rod so it doesn't interfere with the engine. Plus, when I check the oil, I get the correct reading. This is the cover for the starter. It is made by Bach. It is in stainless steel, laser cut. It is absolutely gorgeous and perfect in any way. The original is an ugly plastic piece, and I really absolutely hated it. So I replaced it with this one. Coming closer here, you will see these foot pegs that are made by Puig, P-U-I-G, I believe. They maintain the original spring, just in case of a fall, and they are adjustable. You can actually turn them to get them at the correct angle. As far as the new kickstand, it's an aluminum adjustable one. And if you decide that you want to make one, you can use a Honda one. This actually comes from a Honda, from a Honda 600 CBR. And the only modifications you have to make is there is a small block of metal that you have to install in the back for the cutoff switch to disengage it. Otherwise, your bike will never start once you put it in gear. Here we have the Agostini exhaust. It really makes this engine sound so beautiful. It's the Pavarotti. And this one, the brackets and the foot pegs for the passenger, they are from a V7 racer. Now, I bought this used. Somebody crushed their bike. These were not affected. I bought them. You can actually buy them as a pair, full assembly from AF1 Racing. They cost about $550. They fit perfect, there are no modifications, and they actually fall very close to the original placement. So I would recommend them if you like the look. The socks are by a company made to win. I bought them from Bach, from France. It improved the ride a little bit. Maybe I haven't adjusted them perfectly. I haven't ridden one of those 2018 Sport V9s, which they come with Ohlins. I would suspect that the Ohlins are far better. I have a Tuono over there with Ohlins suspension. It's like a magic carpet. It improves the ride, but not a whole lot. This bike, when it comes to suspension, it is not plush. It is pretty rough, actually. Okay, moving back here. These brackets for the blinkers. The blinkers came from Bach. The brackets themselves, they are made by Motone. And they're actually brackets that Triumph is using. It's the same thing as these brackets, these adapters that I use from Triumph to install the front blinkers. European manufacturers like BMW, Ducati, Moto Guzzi, and Aprilia, they all shop in the same parts bin. So a lot of the parts are interchangeable. You just have to look at them, measure them sometimes, and there is a very good chance that you won't have to modify them. They will fit. And here is these hidden caps. These are the forks on these particular bikes are not adjustable, so they make a cap to go over it. It is beautiful machined and hard anodized. It really gives it a more cleaner look. In the back, we have this rack that are a couple of companies that make them. Moto Guzzi themselves offer two different types. One of them is made specifically for the Roamer, the other one is specifically made for the V9 Bobber, and they do say that that the differences are for the rear, to clear the rear taillight, and also it depends on what type of seat that you use. So some of them are a little higher than the others. This is the specific for V9, and it actually fits very, very well. Moving closer over here, again, these are the original Moto Guzzi. These are called the injector covers. The originals, they can be two different versions. They can be plastic, or they can also be just like these, aluminum, black hard anodized. I didn't like the black hard anodized one, so I replaced them with these. I think that it takes all the blackness away from this bike. It was pretty dark. For the side covers, these, you can buy them directly from Moto Guzzi, or you can also buy them from Bach. They are aluminum, they are hard anodized, they are absolutely gorgeous. And on the other side, I'll show you, you can mount this beautiful leather pouch for the papers of the bike, maybe a couple of small tools and a flashlight if you want to carry. It's the leather is absolutely of the highest quality, and it attaches with like three screws. I did not want to drill my original beautiful ones. I found another pair that they were used. They were imperfect, but I didn't really care because the pouch was going to cover all the imperfections. So that's what I did. In the back, I removed that awful license plate holder that they had. This one comes from Bach, and of course, being that they're a European company, you have to make a few modifications for the American license plates. The actual taillight, it's LED. It's bright enough, but during the night, I actually like to wear a reflective vest. It's kind of small, and if a driver comes at you at a high speed, by the time they see this, it may be a little too late. So, to play it safe, I use a reflective vest. Okay, now, here is something that you may, if you're a little handy with a Dremel, these are the covers, these black covers that you see. These are bolt covers that they're actually made for a Harley to cover the head bolts. Now, obviously, this is a metric bolt bike. Harley is standard. You have to use a Dremel and remove about 2 millimeters worth of metal from the inside. Then you slide them on. There is a set screw, and that's it. I haven't had any problems with them coming loose or anything like that. This over here is the guard made by DPM, by Moto Guzzi, for the master cylinder. And this over here is the cap. Now, they have it listed for the V7. I haven't seen it for the V9. So when I ordered this part, I wasn't too sure whether it's gonna fit or not. To my good luck, it did. The master cylinder is identical and the mounting points are the same. So it does fit. Now, let's see what else we have missed. Now, one thing that I did to this motorcycle and all the other bikes actually that I have is I replaced all the bolts and I replaced them with titanium. This was not a move to make the bike lighter or anything like that. It's just that I absolutely hate those industrial looking gray bolts, which very soon start showing some rust or, corrosion. We all know that titanium doesn't change color, doesn't rust, doesn't do any of that. However, if you decide that you want to do such a thing, and I did it on this bike extensively, I have replaced every single bolt with the exception of the internals in the engine. Every single bolt is titanium. And one thing that I suggest if you decide to do such a thing is make sure you torque them correctly and use some copper grease. Otherwise, the aluminum will gall, they're going to get stuck in there, and working with titanium is not easy. Certainly very difficult drilling it. So I suggest that you use a little bit of lubrication to prevent galling. Anyway, this is my bike. Like I said, I wanted to touch base with all the optional parts that are out there. Like I said, again, some of them are reasonably priced. Some of them are expensive. I remember when I was ordering all these pieces, I had very, very limited amount of pictures on Google and on the catalog. They just show you the part, but they don't show it to you installed. So for those who want to customize their bike and change it around, well, this is what to expect. Now, I would like to mention that the exhaust made the bike run so much better, especially on a hot summer day in traffic. I also had it retuned. They say that you don't have to, but I did anyway. And I didn't notice any difference in performance. It didn't give me any more horsepower or anything like that. But what it did, which was amazing, was the fuel injection works so much better on the hot days. There is no surging of the idle. Everything works like on a normal 60 degree day, which in that respect, it's worth the $500 that you would spend to have it retuned. Another thing that I added to this bike is the EarthX battery, which is a lithium ion. The original battery is a flooded battery. I have had problems in the past. I don't really like them, especially on a fuel injected bike. It's very crucial. You can get stranded because of a battery. Just keep in mind, if you choose to go with EarthX or any other lithium battery, is that once the BMS locks the battery, you do need a charger, a specific charger, to reset the BMS. That may not be possible to jumpstart the bike. And also, on a cold day, the BMS may force the battery to go into a limp mode and not work. But it has to be extremely cold for this to happen. I have started this bike at 20 degrees and I have had no problems whatsoever. So I highly recommend them. One more thing that I forgot to mention was Moroguchi has the MMP, which is a multimedia support. This bike doesn't come with a tachometer. It gives you the outside temperature, it gives you time, it gives you a couple of things. But you can actually have all this data transferred to your iPhone. It connects through Bluetooth. It gives you horsepower figures, torque, a whole bunch of things. Somebody's got a video on the internet if you're interested in installing the module. It can be had for about $200 plus the installation kit, the wiring. That is sold separate. I don't know why they sell it separate. I mean, it should be one. It should come together, but it doesn't. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope that is useful to you. Thank you. Another day, when I figure out, when I get a better camera, I will make a video on this 2008 Tuono, heavily modified, on my Futura, the RST1000, which I'm thinking of selling to make some more room in the garage for other toys, and my 1997 KTM Duke. It was the first version. Anyway, enjoy your evening and see you soon. Bye-bye.